I can't tell a story about taking a shit without 90 people hitting me up the next day telling me that was the most brilliant story in the world. We're going to send it to Tom Segura. Anytime I tell a shit story.
I know,
story,
I'm the shit comic.
Oh, my God.
The best was the night I took a shit in Faberman's backyard after a five-hour drive from Colton or some weird town.
Didn't he not talk to you after that for a
while? Yeah, for a while. I took a shit, and then he ran over it with his car. And the whole backyard smelled like sewage waste. I go over there the next day. He goes, it smells back here. Let's talk in the house. He goes, I don't know what happened. And you can see the brown shit. He smushed it with this tire. And a bunch of flies were around. He didn't talk to me for a month after that. Who takes a shit in somebody's backyard?
How did he find out it was you?
Because I told him the truth. I felt bad. What am I going to lie to the guy?
That's hard to clean up, too.
Wow. Yeah, shit.
You can clean up dog shit. It doesn't even make you gag.
But human
but
shit?
Bum shit?
Yeah. It smells so much stronger, man.
We're gross.
It's so much
more
gross.
No. When you take a shit, it's okay. It's till you cut it in half. You
right.
You cut a shit in half?
No.
When that fucking...
I think I'm
when that
milk,
when that Reese's peanut butter fume leaks out.
Yeah.
Oh, my God.
He's like, I've done studies.